most people are using ChatGPT, like a fancier search engine, to summarize knowledge from around the internet. But now you can actually use ChatGPT to query your own reading history and synthesize answers from all of your highlights. In the rest of this video, I'm going to show you how you can unlock this powerful functionality using the Readwise MCP. To get started, the first thing you're going to want to make sure you've done is imported all of your highlights to Readwise so ChatGPT actually has something to reference. If you've been using Readwise for a while, you probably already have everything connected, but if you're brand new, you can import all of your highlights by creating a free Readwise account using the link below. Once you're logged into your Readwise dashboard, go to Connect and Sync and then click on Import. On this page, you can connect and import highlights from over 30 different sources, including those from Kindle, Pocket, as well as our very own all-in-one reading app called Reader, which is included in your free trial and subscription. You can even import highlights from your paper books using our physical book import feature inside of the Readwise mobile app. Now that your highlights are imported, you can go ahead and install the Readwise MCP inside of ChatGPT. You'll notice here that I'm switching from my personal to a team account. As of right now, only ChatGPT users with Pro, Team, or Enterprise level plans have access to the MCP functionality. If you're using ChatGPT at the free or plus level, you'll need to upgrade to access MCP capabilities or keep your fingers crossed that they roll out this feature to everyone. To start, open Settings from the bottom left corner of your screen. Go to the Connectors option inside the Settings menu sidebar, and then click Create. I'm going to upload the Readwise logo, which you can download for yourself at the documentation page linked below. You can give the connector name any name you want that will make it easy for you to find it in your list. I'd personally recommend just naming it something like Readwise or Readwise MCP to keep things simple. For a description, you can leave this blank or you can enter something like search your Readwise highlights. And then you'll add the Readwise MCP server URL, which again, you can find on our documentations page linked in the video description. Select the OAuth method for authentication, and then check Trust This Application. Just so you know, OpenAI won't use your Readwise data to train its models. Once you click Create, you'll briefly be redirected to the Readwise website to authenticate the connection. Click Authorize to continue. The MCP is now officially installed inside your ChatGPT account. To start chatting with your highlights, turn on the Connected Apps option. Once you have Readwise selected as the source, you won't actually need to include the word highlight in any of your prompts. ChatGPT will automatically default to searching your Readwise highlight database. There's a couple different ways you can chat with your highlights, but one of my favorites is fuzzy or semantic search. So, for example, maybe you're trying to remember a quote or a section of a book that you highlighted, but you can't remember the exact words. You can tell ChatGPT a rough idea of the quote or highlight that you're looking for, and it'll find it for you. So here I described an anecdote I remembered from Byung Chul Han's The Crisis of Narration, which is a fantastic book, by the way, and asked ChatGPT to find it for me. You can see it's searching through my highlight vector database, and it's returned a fuller description of that anecdote. This is more a summary of the idea, but I want a direct quote, so I'm going to ask ChatGPT to find that for me. All right, so this is the full highlight I took. This example is especially useful if you're writing an essay and need to quote something, reviewing a book, or want to share this highlight with a friend or colleague and don't want to flip through all of your highlights to find it. That said, if you do want to see this highlight alongside other highlights you took in the same book or document, ChatGPT will hyperlink to your Readwise database. So you can click on these source links and then see this highlight within the context of other highlights you took in the same document. So semantic search, like I just demonstrated, is one way you can use this MCP to locate a single specific highlight. But you can also ask ChatGPT to synthesize larger takeaways from your reading based on a combination of your highlights. For example, The Crisis of Narration was a pretty complex philosophical book. It's been a few months since I read this book in full, and I'm going to ask ChatGPT to refresh my memory on exactly how Byung Chul Han defined the narrative crisis using the actual highlights I took in the book. Here's its response, and I can follow up this question by asking what solutions Han proposed to this crisis. This is an example of how you can use the Readwise MCP to synthesize answers from one specific book, but you can also have it synthesize answers from across documents. For example, I'm going to ask it to outline some common mistakes early product managers make. As you can see, I'm also providing a little bit of direction on how it can format its response for easier legibility. All right, here's the takeaways the Readwise MCP has synthesized using my highlights from 6 different books and articles. So that's a quick preview of two ways you can use the Readwise MCP to remember more of what you read inside of ChatGPT. If you have other fun use cases, I'd love to hear about them in the comments. In addition to the Readwise MCP, we also built an all-in-one reading app. So if you're interested in doing more reading, you should check out this video next.